Harris is in the backfield. The Redskins take it from the 23. Had it for just a second, but then it came out on that one. So, second down here. Alfred Morris lined up in the backfield. He'll throw it over the middle. That's dropped by Reed, who couldn't bring it in.
One player to watch on this defense today is Dan Williams.
Veteran defensive lineman that knows how to play. He's tough. He can occupy the run, tackle guys, and also athletic enough to still get to the quarterback.
It's third down coming up. Reed's a receiver all the way out to the right. From the gun. Almost intercepted that time.
The Redskins put them with that play call and that throw by the quarterback.
First down at the 32. Smith all over the ball carrier.
Got to get the deep, pick up those extra yards. Good job by the quarterback and receiver that time.
The Redskins get set at the line, needing to get to the 22 for a first. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down.
The Raiders guess right on the deep.
Griffin's going to take it from the gun. Intercepted. What a time to throw a pick, Phil. This defense, though, out of the shotgun. Alden Smith with the quarterback takedown.
That's an...
First down at the 21. Reed with the grab. And that's a gain of 10. That's his first reception today. No need to huddle. Hurry up offense. The Redskins snap it at the 31. Finds Reed. He's tackled right at the 48.
Doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing the play to the receivers by giving him hand signals.
Good yardage picked up on that call.
There's no doubt time of possession can be an overrated stat in games many times, but one thing you want to do, throw and catch it just like this to pick up those first downs and keep it going.
Wasting little time. Jordan Reed has the reception. They'll run it here. And Edwards is able to read that play and make the hit.
The Redskins offensive coordinator, he has to be frustrated by that play. I think he calls the right play, but what happens? The run loses yards. That's just a bad job by the offensive line.
This is third down. Quarter underway now with this snap, and it's incomplete.
I don't think there was a miscommunication between the receiver and the quarterback. The quarterback just overthrew the pass.
The coach is going to go for it. The Raiders will come out in the dime. The Redskins from the 32. The Redskins turn the ball over on downs.
The Redskins go for it on fourth down, and they do not get it done. Now it's it's up to their defense.
What is up, guys? I'm Mikey at 31 here. Saw a glimpse of some Raiders Tampa 2 action out of the Cover 2 playbook. And going to be going over in part one of this Tampa 2 breakdown for Madden 16. I will be going over roster setup. Part two will be the actual playbook itself, what I play, 4-3 stack, wide 9, 4-6, under, over, and the nickel, you know, and dime sub packages and all that good stuff. And then part three will be my custom audibles. Now, part one here is not to be discounted at all, because outside of, you know, your play calling, who you have where is going to be very important. Set it up right, and then when you learn how to run it, it's going to be very effective. You're going to cause a lot of problems for a lot of people, and they'll be wondering when they see the previous play call, how the hell are they not able to move the football? But, you know, and of course, not all teams are created equal. Some teams are going to be better than others because they have better players. But we can at least optimize your roster of choice to give you the best shot of doing it. And I'm using the Raiders here in honor of the late Madden Edge, who was a great contributor to the Madden Sim strategic community, who passed away this past year. Big Raider fan and a big source of info for improving your Madden game with non-cheese, real football world tactics. So, rest in peace, Madden Edge. But as far as his beloved Raiders go, here's how I have him set up. Left end, right end. Left end, quote-unquote, the strong side. We don't really have true strong side, weak side positions in the game, so I play it boundary field. So my boundary defensive end, and I'll show you how I do my substitution packages in my base 4-3 sets to get him always on the side that I want him. My boundary defensive end, I want him more of a run defender. If he's a pass rusher, that's great, but first I want the boundary end, because he's more than likely going to be on the strong side, to the tight end side, to be a run defender. And Mario Edwards here, the rookie. It came down to him or Lorenzo Alexander. Lorenzo Alexander, I decided, was a bit too slow. Mario Edwards, even though his awareness is 48 as a rookie, and his play rec, you know, is 60. I just picked him because he's a better athlete. And if you use your lineman, you'll be able to do some good things as far as block shedding goes. He's stronger than Lorenzo Alexander. He's got better acceleration. He's more agile. He's got better speed at 78. So when you QB contain him, he'll be harder to get wide of. Got better tackling, hip power isn't as great, and his pass rush moves isn't that great, but Lorenzo Alexander will still play because in dime, I'm going to substitute him at defensive tackle because the Raiders defensive tackles, they're more run defenders as opposed to pass rushers. So when we go four DEs, he'll still be on the field. But Mario Edwards, he has that 87 block shedding, which is going to be very useful on that strong, quote-unquote, strong side. I'm just going to call it boundary side, field side. So on that boundary side, he's going to be able to hold that edge down. along with your boundary backer. Alden Smith, he'll play the field side defensive end. I think it's logical to have your most athletic, best pure pass rush defensive end always on that side, because if the QB could, scrambles wide, why wouldn't you want your most athletic defensive end playing that wide nine technique or that seven technique on that field side? And Alden Smith, you know, you don't got to worry about intangibles here in a video game world. He'll get it done for you. 81 speed, 86 strength, 87 agility, 84 acceleration. You know, slightly on the dumb side, but you got Justin Tuck here as a backup when you go 4 DEs as well. And 88 tackling, 87 hit power, 93 power move, 83 block shedding. You saw him blow up some runs in that footage earlier. And again, when you go NASCAR, you have Alden Smith, you have Justin Tuck, you have Khalil Mack to choose from, as well as Alexander. 93 pursuit, I mean, he can get it done. 78 play rec is okay. You could even hook him into his zones as well, with 69 zone coverage from time to time. Defensive tackles, ideally, I want a good combination of pass rushing and run defense for my number one defensive tackle. He's going to be playing the three technique position, the Warren Sapp spot, where he's going to be in that guard tackle gap, and you want a guy who can penetrate that gap, get in the backfield, make things happen. Your number two defensive tackle, he's going to be your nose. He's going to be your one and zero technique. He needs to be strong enough to take on doubles and shed those double team blocks also. More of a run defender. Think of the Williams wall back when the Vikings played Tampa 2. They had the Williams twins and Jared Allen, and they would routinely lead the league in run defense. They'd just laugh at people trying to run between the tackles. You couldn't do it. You know, Pat and Kevin Williams, and you had Jared Allen rushing on the edge. You know, think of the Panthers with Starr and Kiwan Short. That kind of interior presence on your defensive tackle. Dan Williams, he's got 96 strength. He's not going to get pancaked very often. 87 awareness, he'll be able to sniff out screens. 94 tackling. Not a great pass rusher at 82, but he's got that 95 block shedding, 88 pursuit, 86 play rec. So he's not going to be fooled by screens a lot. He's a nice hoss. Of course, you know, the best three technique style defensive tackle in this game that you can put here would be J.J. Watt. If you go from a 3-4 to a 4-3, J.J. Watt, my God. I mean, he's a beast. Geno Atkins is very good. Star Lotelli is very good. You got quite a few defensive tackles who are very good in this game who can play that role, or 3-4 defensive ends who can play that role. On my Jets, I have, you know, several. I have Sheldon Richardson, Muhammad Wilkerson, and the Rook. You know, so some teams have a plethora of options here for this spot. Leonard Williams, he can play that spot for me as well. Justin Ellis, he'll be my nose. Since neither one's a great pass rusher, you can even flip-flop them if you want. If you want Dan Williams to be the guy who anchors those double teams, because he's strong enough to fight through them and good enough block shedder to fight through them. But I want the better pass rush move, because he'll be one-on-one more often than not in the interior line, just based on how he's going to be aligned. Khalil Mack, he will be my boundary backer. And I drop him to defensive end on this team as well, on the dime and in the nickel. Nickel wide nine, I should say. Nice and fast. What makes the Tampa 2 go is speed. Speed along the front seven and athleticism. Being able to rally to the ball. And he's got that in spades. 87 speed. 92 acceleration. Awareness is decent. It could be higher, but hey, he's only been in the league 1 year. So they're not going to give him very high awareness. 93 tackling, 86 hit power, 87 power moves. He'll be useful, you know, on blitzes, on five-man rushes and all that good stuff. Good block heading for that boundary side, that strong side. 93 pursuit. 79 play rec is decent, and he's got 78 zone coverage, so he'll be good in those hook and curl flat zones. Middle backer is Curtis Lofton. I like 80 and above for the speed at this position, but he's got 88 acceleration, so we can live with that. You know, that'll compensate for that some. Good tackler, good hit power. You know, block shedding is borderline, but you have these two guys in front of him that are going to help him out. So, you know, you can get by with this. The big thing for him is going to be that 72 zone coverage. Now, the beauty of these linebackers here for the Raiders are pretty athletic with this kind of setup is that in dime, what I can do, I can even put in Malcolm Smith here with his 88 speed and 75 zone coverage to man that deep middle when I hot route him blue. Or even Khalil Mack at 78. I mean, you've got a lot of ways you can go. I mean, you can go in the dime, say Justin Tuck at one end, Alden Smith at the other, and put, you know, Mario Edwards at the three technique in your dime, Khalil Mack at middle linebacker. I mean, you got some flexibility here. They're really not that bad at all, the Raiders, as far as defense goes. Offense, a little bit of a different story, but defense, they have some pieces. They really do. And Malcolm Smith here, he is my open side of the field backer, quote-unquote, will backer. Help shield him. I mean, between a guy like Alden Smith on the open side of the field and this guy, this type of guy running down with his 88 speed, and his 83 pursuit with decent play rec, you'll be able to close those kind of runs down. And 75 zone coverage is good enough. I want low 70s at the bare minimum. 75 and above is fine. Corners. I decided to go with Keith McKill as my number one corner for this scheme, for this team. Mainly because he's 6'3". I mean, hello. He's 6'3". Awareness is kind of meh. But he can really tackle. Cover two hard corners have to be able to tackle because they're going to be playing force on those tosses and on those stretches and off-tackle runs. He can tackle. He's got 71 hit power. You can even go DJ Hayden at number two to give you 77 and 62. 77 and 71 hit power on your corners, on the edges there. He's got good pursuit. He can press at 88. He's the best press coverage guy, so that's going to be a big help when I play man one robber. And I'm not really concerned with the man coverage because more often than not, I'm going to have him up in the face of a receiver. And if I'm in man two, he's going to have help. But he's got 84 zone coverage. So I figure with his height and his tackling and hitting ability and his press coverage ability, he's perfect with this kind of scheme. I mean, you don't need diva corners for a Tampa 2. You don't need a Patrick Peterson. You need guys who are physical, can play the run, can tackle, and can press. And you can, you know, mix and match here, go wherever you choose for that spot, or for those spots there. Free safety, Nate Allen. I was using him. He's pretty good on his own. He's fast enough. He's got decent awareness. He's got 75 spec catch. That's going to help him go up for those, you know, INTs with these receivers down the field. That comes in handy. Charles Woodson has 77 spec catch. So if you have defensive backs with spec catch, that helps you out big time. He's got 87 jumping. He's a good little athlete there. Not the best tackler in the world, but good enough. 75 play rec. Borderline, but I'll take it. And 81 zone coverage. Anything under 75 with play rec kind of scares me. And deep safety, you know, 80 and above for a deep half safety for me, or a single high safety. Anything below that, anything below the 75 to 77 range at the bare minimum is scary. And Charles Woodson, the genetic freak. I'm surprised his play rec and awareness aren't higher than they are. Oh, it's 94. When he goes to free safety, it drops for some reason, but 94 awareness. 73 catching. 77 spec catch. 83 jumping. So he'll be able to go up for the ball. You don't got to worry about that. And of course, you can always switch to play ball, play receiver as appropriate. You know, so-so tackler. His play rec's 83. You could play big nickel with him, put him in a slot, and press people. And his zone coverage is 83. So against three wide receiver sets, you can go big nickel or big dime. That'll roll him into the slot or into the box. And you can play, you know, press coverage on slot receivers. And still have some pretty, and still have better run support than having a standard, you know, nickel corner there. Even though the nickel corners for the Raiders can, you know, tackle pretty well and play the run pretty well. But if you don't have nickel corners that can do that, I would recommend the basing out of big nickel or big dime against teams or against guys who like to come out in, you know, 11 personnel, one back, one tight end, three wide receivers, either out of the shotgun or single back, at least on base downs. Then on passing situations, play out of a normal nickel or dime set. So that is how I have my roster set up, generally speaking, to run a Tampa 2. And of course, some teams, you know, vary here and there, but those are generally my rules for each position. Boundary side, defensive end, stout run defender, and his pass rush is a bonus. Open side defensive end, my most athletic pass rushing defensive end. Defensive tackle, my three technique is going to be my best all-around defensive tackle. My 4-3, 1, and 0 technique, my nose is going to be my run plugger. My boundary side backer is going to be my hammer to play, you know, run support first and foremost. He doesn't have to be a great zone coverage guy because he'll have the least amount of ground to cover. And I like to send him off the edge on blitzes as well from the boundary. So Khalil Mack fits that bill pretty nicely. Middle backer has to be rangy and have good zone coverage and good tackling. Doesn't have to be the best block shedder in the world if he has hosses in front of him. And your boundary, not your boundary, but your field side backer has to be a guy who can run like a deer, pursue, tackle, and play good zone coverage as well. Corner's got to be physical, got to play press coverage, got to be able to tackle. And your safety's got to be able to play deep zone coverage as well. So those are my general rules. And in part two, I'll go over the cover two playbook, the formations, when I call what, the sub packages that are in those formations to get the guys in their right roles, and go over the different variations of cover two that are in the game and how they work. Cover two hard, cover two press, the new way cover two sync is designed, and also things like cover three cloud, cover six, zone blitzes, and all that good stuff as well. So that is it for now. Hope you guys enjoy. Talk to you all later. Peace.